card invitation again. Hold on a second, people. I have to accept this party invitation. You know. Hello? Shit. Ugh, damn it. Hello? Okay. That's cool. Okay, everyone, so, whoever's watching, shit, I only died that one time because I was accepting a party invite, so, yeah, and because of that, my character was standing in one spot for too long, and then got killed, so, a friend of mine wanted me to really join their party, so that's what I did, let me join the parties. Okay, well. Yeah, I haven't switched to this one. Okay, so he is. So, yeah. See. I don't know why I did that. Okay, I had to mute there, mic, because I don't know if they want to be in the broadcast. They always be in the broadcast, so I muted someone's mic because of that. Anyways, hello? You're back. Cool. Yeah, I just accepted your invite. And because of that, I died in the dungeon, so... Yeah, I ended up dying because I had to accept your invite. And on top of it, I'm broadcasting, so because of that, people saw me come back and have to, like, get revived and shit. Resurrected and whatnot. They're probably like, okay, you were just alive, now why are you dead? So, yeah. But yeah, if you are watching my broadcast, then you can see my warrior. If you are watching. I don't know because someone is watching, but I just don't know who. But yeah. But, yep. I was kicked out of the Shiny Pennies Guild because the guildmaster doesn't know that this is, like, one of my accounts. And so, I got kicked out of it, so I'm looking to join a guild. And then join one that was our, like, open enrollment, but, there's like, 53 people in it, and 45 accounts. And no one's on but me. There was one person on besides me, but they left the guild. Like 10 minutes after I joined, they left the guild. So now I'm looking for guild that's got active players. So I'm probably gonna leave this one very soon. The one I'm in. Well, I have characters on a PvE server, but I haven't really played my characters too much. All closest I've ever gotten to 65 was basically like 62 for my Berserker that is on, on a PvE server. So, yeah. What now? Cool. This dungeon is done for. Okay. I went to bed at like 1 a.m. I was really tired. So I'm up. That's why I'm up at this time of the day. Which, you know, I never am, but that's why I am. Yeah, I didn't get very good much sleep yesterday. My mom had woken me up, you know, before she had to take the dogs to the groomers. Like, three of them to the groomers. So, yeah, and then I went back to sleep while she was gone, and I only got like an hour of sleep from that. So that's why I went to bed so early at like 1 in the morning. I would have been on GTA if I wasn't so tired, but I wasn't even on GTA because I was so tired. So it's like Netflix and then bed. But yeah, I'm going to be on Netflix. Not Netflix, I'm going to be on GTA later and every day this week because they're giving out free money for the after hours DLC. But anyone that owns a nightclub gets a bunch of money every day. So I don't know how much money we're getting today, but I know one day you get 250,000, and then another day you get 500,000, then 800,000, then 1,000,000, and 200,000. But I don't know how much we're getting today. And I think that's what you get. I just know that starting today on the 11th until like the 18th, you get money every day for logging in. And I think anybody who doesn't have a club would probably get the money too, because it's the after hours DLC. So hopefully everyone gets it, not just the people that own clubs. Because it'd be unfair to those people. I think I'll do the PvE server because, you know, I haven't really gotten a character on a PvE server to, like, 65, or I have played on one for very long. I played up to, like, I think 62 on my Berserker, but I don't have a 65 character on a PvE server, and none of my characters on the PvE server are even in a guild, none of that. So, yeah, I think I might actually, you know, make a character on a PvE server and try to get it to, you know, 65 and have it in a guild and all that whatnot. So, yeah. So, I think I'll do that. So, yeah. It'd be cool to actually do that. Because on PC, I have a character, you know, it's like 63, almost 65, and it's in a guild and stuff like that. So, yeah, I actually have, like, characters I played on a PvE server for quite a bit of time. One of my accounts actually does have a few characters, so like 65 and whatnot, but yeah, so I have played on a PvE server and a PvP server. On PC Terror, I started out on a PvP server, and then I ended up at one point just making a character on a PvE server and played on that for quite a time. It's quite some time. So yeah, I might actually do that. Well, and especially in here, it's going to be PvE servers, it's going to be in Terra console, a lot more active and whatnot, so yeah. So yeah, I actually might, you know, make a character on a PvE server and play that too. Plus I have a friend of mine that I didn't even know play Terra. He just started playing Terra like in the past week and a half for the first time ever. And yeah, he's playing on a PvE server, which is cool. Who is the leader here? Okay, we'll find out. Okay, I'm not the leader, but the person who is the leader is not in here. Yep. Yeah. Yeah, I haven't even played it yet, but yeah. It's downloaded. Oh, this is just great. Oh, so I'm in a dungeon, and two people have not loaded in, and they look like they're dead. And one person who hasn't loaded in is, like, the leader. So, we could kick him, but I don't know if that's going to do anything. And I just did the dungeon with them, like, a few minutes ago. And we're doing the dungeon again, but they're the leader, so we're going to have to kick them. Hopefully it makes someone else the leader who's at, okay, someone else is the leader, cool. So yeah. Mm-hmm. Kinda weird, but well, at least one person in the dungeon got made leader. That's my dog. In the background. Yeah. Damn. Sounds funny. Yeah. Interesting. Interesting logic.